lightning storm going on behind me. Probably 10 miles, 15 miles, you've been getting lightning and who knows, maybe hail. Oh. Well, we went around and I think up north is ready. It looks more ready than what this is here. And here's the thing, we still have weed across. We call it across the interstate. It's our farthest land away. It's where we were cutting that winter wheat earlier, you guys saw. It's where we took the commons across that bridge. Well, we're gonna go across that bridge with these things. It's gonna be fun. So we're gonna head over there right now. We're gonna hit that spring wheat. We've got about 2 days, so we'll finish the stuff across the interstate and then everything up north here is ready to go too. That way we can just move on through in one big sweeping motion. So it just means shuffling everything around. But we got a lot of drivers. We should be good. Let's hit the road.
Okay, there we go. We just brought the two combines and we brought the three semis over here across the interstate. And we're gonna start chopping away at 500 acres. We still need to bring the big brute and the service truck over here. Let's get to it. Find out what I got for lunch. That is a spitting image of leg arms. She's good.
So we got started today and picked up from where we left off last night. This field's pretty long and it drops over a hill and we got on the other side of the hill and it is wet. It's not ready to cut here, too green. So we just had a powwow and decided we're gonna head and do a quick crop tour. Now we're gonna run around scout, see if we can find some fields that look like they're riper and ready to go. If we can get a big enough area, because we hate moving. If we get a big enough area that looks ripe all around, we'll get everything moved there, spend a day or two knocking out part of the farm, and then eventually come back here and finish this when it ripens. It just needs more time, it's just not there yet. So, we just got the 8250 back in the field. We're burning through the acres quick.
It's awesome.
And that thing is amazing. Leg arms is having a ball in it. So with leg arms and the 8250, my buddy Chad in the B-spine and my dad in Clifford, I'm coming over here to check out this bin site here because I think this one's about full. They hold about 4 semi-loads. I'm gonna climb up there, I'm gonna take a look inside. If it's close, I gotta move to the next bin because there's another semi coming. 3 combines rolling means a lot of product coming off the fields, even though we're only cutting like 25 bushels spring weight. It's pretty sad, unfortunately. But that's okay, we'll keep moving. Well, it's almost full. It's really close. This is a tough decision because it'd be really nice just to move over, but you could probably fit another 300 some bushel in here. Is it worth it to wait and then have the truck move off again to move everything and have the truck roll back on again? I'll probably wait. Mission accomplished. Auger's moved, truck's dumping, RJ's doing a great job, back to the field. I got combines to chase the drone. It's that time in the morning. We're back in the field. Everything's gotta get greased, fueled, clean. Maintenance, adjust, cutter bar here's gotta get fixed. Got leg arms. Chad, old roommate of mine back in college. Brad, you guys met Brad. I figured I better stop by the bin site because these bins only hold so much grain and sometimes you lose track of how many loads are in a bin and before you know it, you're blowing grain off the top of the yard because it's full. I'm gonna climb up, I'm gonna measure it, just check, see how many more trucks we can fit. It's lunchtime after that, so I'll race back to the field, get some grub. She is plumb full. Whew, that was almost a wreck. I gotta move the auger. Always make sure your doors are shut. If you don't, you're gonna have a spill in front of your door. And when grain's coming out, it's a lot harder to close the door. Good. Brad's going. Truck's good. Tractor's good. Bin's good. I'm gonna race back. Let's get some food. I'm in the combine with leg arms. He's been running an 8250 for quite a while now. All day, most of yesterday, getting some good hours in it. And we keep looking back at the grain tank. It is so well thrashed back there. If that were our sample and our other combines all the time, we would be thrilled. And we keep trying. We've actually tried to even match the settings of the 8250 on our 8230s, and we still can't get it as clean as it is back here. And here's the other thing. How fast are you cutting right now?
Right now I'm cutting about 7.2 miles an hour. This is just pounding out acres. I'm literally passing the other combines, like lapping them.
So this has what's called feed rate control, and basically the combine will take over and will run this speed or the acceleration as fast as it needs to feed the combine as much product as it needs. Well, since this crop is so thin, this combine says, hey, I can handle more. So we set you set the top speed to 7.5, is that what it was?
Yeah, I kept on increasing it just to see what it would do and how it handled and how it's cutting the wheat, because I didn't want to go too fast where I'm not cutting the wheat.
That's a pretty sight. So basically what's going on is the combine is capable of handling not much wheat. So it's going 7+ miles an hour, grain loss is low, threshing is great. Here's the thing, our 8230s have 45 foot headers, so they're 5 feet longer, but they are going about 2 to 3 miles an hour slower in the field because, not that they can't handle it, the horsepower is there. It's that if they go any faster, they're gonna start throwing grain out of the back. The loss goes way up, we start feeding them heavier, and the tank gets dirtier. So we have to manually keep the combine slowed back, not utilizing all the power it has, because we're gonna be throwing grain out the back and the tank's gonna get dirtier. This combine takes care of all of that and maximizes. So this combine with a 40 foot header is actually outcutting our 8230s by about 5 acres per hour, which is huge. That's it, finished over here. That's 500 acres of spring wheat in 2 days. Could have done that in 1 day, but we didn't get a full day in yesterday. So we are gonna go across the interstate and get some other stuff. But everybody's getting ready to road. So I'm gonna run down, jump in the combine that Chad's in. I'll take over for him because it's a little tricky maneuvering that thing back across the road. And we'll all meet up on the other side. Playing a game of musical trucks. Just the way the trucks are turning out with the three and the two drivers, they keep jumping into different trucks. And one guy's like, I'll take that one, I'll take this one, I'll take that one. So I got RJ's truck now. It's got enough to fill this bin. I'm gonna climb up there, take a look, see how much room I have left. I'll have to run down, shut it all off when it's closed, and then I'm gonna move everything to the next bin. These bins only hold like just barely 4,000 bushels, like 3,800. So not a lot. I bet it's almost full. I better take a look. Got a little bit of room left. I think I'll take the front hopper, the truck for sure, and almost all the back, and then I gotta move it. The guys are just knocking those acres down fast. This field probably only yielding 17 bushels an acre. I think it's under 20. Pretty sad. It was recrop on peas, wheat on peas. It would have yielded a little better if we didn't have done that, but the fact that we grew peas on it last year, so we made money on peas, and we'll be making money on wheat. So it's good, it's just not the yields we want, but I mean, we didn't get the rain, so you can't ask for much more than that. No rain, no crop, it's just how it is. All right, well, it's taking the front hopper. There might be enough room to fit the back hopper of the trailer in there. I'm gonna run down and try it. Let's see if we can do it. It's gonna be close, it's gonna be really close. I think it'll fit, but it's gonna be close. There's just a little bit left in that hopper. There's just a little bit of room left in here. I'm gonna run down there, crank the gate open, and close my eyes and plug my ears and hope that nothing comes out. Go do it. Here we go. Leg arms was filling. I had to run over there. He was dumping grain atop my grain trailer with his combine. I was like, it's full, no more. It's okay, I think we're good. Oh, another day. So we're out there, we're rolling to the field, and guess what? Yeah, pretty sure the guys are getting shut down right now. this could be enough to stop us for at least the afternoon. Oh well, we'll see what we can do. But we're heading back out. They're out in the field right now, and it is getting greasy. Well, they did forecast some rain today, and it came. It did come, as you can see. So they're cooling the combines down, shutting them down. A250 sitting back here, obviously with this rain. There's not gonna be any cutting probably today. Bummer. I know a lot of you think, hey, the 250 is automated, right? Does it fuel itself? No, it doesn't. You still gotta put diesel in it. And as far as I understand, it burns actually less diesel than the other ones, but it does burn a lot more DEF. Fortunately, the DEF tank's pretty much full. Well, it dried out. The sun did come out. Surprisingly, not, it's not now, but it did come out enough. The wind did blow. The guys are in the field right now cutting. The local Hutterite colony, those guys are rolling. They stopped by afterwards. They got rained out just with us. They're right over here with their four 8120s, two grain carts. Got a sweet operation. Got a neighbor down there, the Rogers. They're running their 7088 in the field. And right over here, our other neighbors got their John Deere's parked at the moment, but I bet they'll get going soon. So the whole area is alive. It's moving. Trucks are rolling again. Crops getting cut. And I'm gonna take this girl for a spin. I've had a number of people ask, how do you mount your flags on your combines? And normally I'm like, well, it's kind of hard to show you because the flag is way out there on the auger. But guess what? The collapsible auger on this, the transport mode or storage mode, whatever you want to call it, brings it real close. So if you look carefully, you see an old chain. And what leg arms did is you wrapped the chain around, welded it to an old feeder bar with a pipe stub on it, and then just had a bolt and a nut, and you just tighten the bolt down, tightens the chain up tight. As long as it doesn't wiggle, shouldn't scratch the paint. Just so you guys know, you gotta make sure that your pole, whatever you're using on that flag, is one, easy to break, like use a PVC pipe or aluminum or something simple. I prefer plastic, because that way if you touch a power line, you're gonna have less chance of grounding out the power line to the ground. Two, make sure it swivels in there. That's the whole point of that pipe. It's inside the sleeve here, and it's got room to flex, because when the wind blows, you want that flag to move in the direction of the wind. Otherwise, when you go around the field around, 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 you'll wrap that flag around that pole so tight that it'll just be a rod again, and then you have to somehow unravel it. Did that one year, not a good idea. Okay, that's it for this field. That means we get to head south, back towards the farmyard, which is awesome because that means we're back close to the farm, good self-service, live streams, and great access to the kitchen at home, because that means I can go home and snack when I need to. All right, let's get this thing in road mode. I need to just dump in a truck, close the hopper, fold the auger, burn down the road to the next field.
I am not gonna cut all this kochia and shove it through this combine. It's not necessary for the combine to be moaning and groaning, trying to get this stuff pushed out the back. I'm lifting the header up and just gonna drive right over it. Kochia is a nasty weed.
We hate it.
He hates it.
I dislike it. For the passion.
Now that I got through the kochia, I was able to put the header back down and start cutting some wheat. Awesome.
What's going on there? Isn't that pretty? Wait, we wanna get a close-up on that? Let's get a close-up on that. What's that right there? Right there, right my crosshairs.
Hey, that's filming in the making. History in the making.
Oh, wrong button.
Oh, he just hit the wrong button.
Oh no.
I ran
inside
the
car. Oh, no, no.
We're gonna need red paint. This field's done. Beautiful lightning storm going on behind me. Been trying really hard to capture some awesome strikes. Fortunately, that thing missed us. Not by a lot, probably 10 miles. 10 or 15 miles would have probably started getting a little bit of water. 15 miles, you'd be getting lightning and who knows, maybe hail. There's probably guys harvesting over there right now that are getting shut down. Oh, that was a good one. We'll be right back.